One of the big keys to canine scent work is really nailing down the yes zone when it comes to whether you should verify an alert on a target odor from your dog. However, what is the best way to know when you're in the sweet spot, especially when accessibility to target odor is not always an option? Well, in today's episode, we're going to talk a little bit about airflow and how you can use an app to visualize scent in motion so you never miss an alert call again. Let's get after it. Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Dingle Days. I'm Geryah Dingle, the canine scent boss, and I'm fired up to share a few techniques to think about scent in motion and how you can use an app to do the thinking for you. You know, because technology. But real quick, this channel is all about my journey with my German Shepherd dog, Disney, as we walk through the basics of canine scent work, pet photography, and the best pet technology to complement your productive lifestyle. So if that sounds like something that interests you, consider subscribing. So how does scent move? We actually have to take it back a bit to our old school physics and chemistry days, but don't worry, it's not gonna be too deep. There's just one simple concept we have to remember. High pressure flows to low pressure when there's more energy or velocity in that direction of travel. I know, we're making a few simplifying assumptions here for my science nerds in order to use this concept and treat all scents like ideal gases. So since we know that smell is nothing but actual molecules moving through the air, it's important to understand how we can reverse engineer the scent path to help our dogs identify the source odor and not call our dogs off the scent during the search. Scent work dogs are working through a puzzle of sorts where a scent came from an object, moved through the air, and is now affixed to the olfactory nerves in their noses so they can detect it, and they have a lot of these. A dog's olfactory epithelium is 20 times bigger than a human's, with up to 300 million scent receptors. These are the actual neurons that detect smells, the taste buds of the nose, if you would. But why do we care about this science anyway? Well, the wind tunnel app, much like its namesake, uses particles to show you how air would move or act around an object you insert or draw. This simulates air movement around a shape that you draw to show wind swirling, wind speed, and pressure. Let's use the wind tunnel app and its smoke feature to visualize flow structures our dogs may interact with in the real world. We start to see top separation as some of the wind flows over an object. Behind the object, streamlines are bent due to low pressure inside the separation bubble. Inside the separation bubble, it's very turbulent and the speed of wind is significantly lower inside. You'll see a backwards directed flow in the separation bubble, commonly known as swirling. Here are a few other flow structures that are important to understand when visualizing scent in motion. I'm going to pick a few images of flow structures, and one that's really common is the wind effect. And you can see this in a typical household. There's always going to be some seam crack where the airflow is coming in. And so what's going to happen is the air is going to continue to travel even inside the house in the direction of the wind that's outside. And this is called the wind effect. The stronger the wind, the stronger the effect. There's another type of flow structure, which is known as the stack effect. And let's say I have a house that's multiple stories. Let's say it's three stories. We all know that heat generally rises, right? And so that's gonna occur with our scents as well. And the taller the building, the more you're gonna see this effect, but this is called the stack effect. The taller the building, the more the effect is actually going to be evident. Another common force flow structure is known as pooling. So let's say we have our little target odor here, and it's sitting on a counter, but the wall's back here, and my dog's over here. So Disney is probably going to get a hint of the odor because of something called pulling. And what you're gonna see back here is a bit of swirling, but the scent is going to pull down here, and then he'll be able to locate it. Another type of force flow structure is something known as funneling. If my scent was down here on the floor, the scent is going to permeate up and away from the target odor. And that'll be another way for my dog to find it. And lastly, you'll see something called eddying. And eddying might occur, let's say we have some trees outside, and these are basically just like objects in the way. And let's say the wind is blowing in this general direction. If the wind hits the tree as this object, you're gonna see the wind and your scent sort of whip around and make it really confusing in that area. Okay, so this is when you might see your dog do a little bit of that 180 that you see. And this is known as eddying. So I hope that helps illustrate how scent acts in motion with some of these scent flow diagrams. Or maybe you're outside a building and you're searching for an odor. And let's say the building is shaped like this. And generally speaking, the wind is flowing over the building in this direction. So you're gonna see something kind of like that happen. In these pocket areas, you're going to see a little bit of swirling. And you might even have some dead areas where the air is not even flowing, and it's gonna be really difficult for your dog to find odor here if the odor were here. So you might have to take your dog back here and ensure that they are actually checking out all of the areas just based on what we know about scent in motion. So how does airflow affect the search? Well, let's talk about trailing dogs that are often used in law enforcement searches, but the same scenarios apply to searches at home. If, for example, your dog is following a scent trail on a path a person has walked and suddenly detects the same odor in the wind coming from a direction where the subject is currently located, the dog should follow the air scent and deviate from the footpath, even if the subject did not walk in this new direction. Few dogs will stop immediately where there is a scent change. Instead, they generally keep moving in the original direction. As the scent cone vanishes to nothing, a dog often stops and begins to quarter into the wind. You'll see that little whip around that they do in an attempt to relocate the odor. The problem with this technique is that the size and scope of the scent cone could be huge. The target odor may have been spread out over hundreds of meters past the original trail or perhaps over a crossroad. If their handler fails to recognize a dog's subtle change in behavior or their body language, they run the risk of the odor being overshot, and the dog could get so far off the actual trail that they might not even find it again. However, if the handler recognizes the body language cues as their dog manifests them, they'll be far better suited to use what we know about scent in motion, relocate the trail, and be enabled to recast their dog in the right direction. Distractions versus airflow. I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge that many handlers don't recognize the subtle distracting odors that take their dogs off target. And even when they do recognize distraction behavior, they're often hesitant to correct the problem because maybe they're unsure about the distraction and the basic tenets that we're trying to define here with regard to scent in motion. It's important that every scent work nose work dog have distraction training in which the distractions are diverse and known to you as the handler in a multitude of environments. The Wind Tunnel app is a tool that can give you a good idea on how to choose search areas that will present the appropriate level of difficulty for your dog. So to get started, check out my complete rundown of how to set up an AKC Scentwork Novice practice area by clicking or tapping the screen right here for my canine scentwork practice video, or check the links in the description below for more awesome videos. I hope you got value out of this episode. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Dingle Days, and check us out on the Dogs Are People Too podcast or the link blog post in the description below. Until next time, continue to get after it.